Hello friends, in this Java tutorial, we will learn about the objects. The topics are casting of objects, comparing objects, copying objects, and determining the object class. Okay, so we start with the casting of objects, and please subscribe to my channel, and if you like my videos, please share. Okay, so let's start with the casting of objects. So let's start with the casting. So what is casting? The first point is what is casting? The converting the value of an object or primitive data type into another type is known as the casting. What are the primitive types? Primitive types means basic data types like int, bool and float. Like these are the 8 basic data types. Okay, so let's first start with these primitive basic data types. So like if you want to convert or type casting a float value to int value or other, so int have sort byte, int and long, 4 type, and float contains float and double, and another one is bool. Okay, and last one is the char. So actually we are not considering here this, only these primitive types, integer, bool and float. Okay, these only. So let's start. Okay, so we can do casting of values like two ways, like smaller to larger. And another one is larger to smaller. Here the casting takes automatic by the Java, because here no loss of info, that's why it is automatic. Okay, and on this way maybe loss of info, or you can say information, that's why we use explicit typecasting here. Okay, so how we do typecasting? So the syntax is type name and value. This is the syntax. Okay, when we use type casting the first way, like smaller to longer, so there is no need of explicit type casting. It is automatically done by the Java. Like I have a number like 4, okay, and I want to, like x equal to 4, and I want to put in a variable like y, like y equal to 0, and this is an int type and it is a long variable. So this is the long. If I want to typecast like this y equal to x, so here we do not need to explicit typecast, because this y is a long type variable that is a larger than integer, and this is x is an integer type. Okay, so this is smaller and this is the big one, so there is no need of typecasting. Like is y is this, and axis, this. Okay, so this is easily fit into this Y. So we need not to explicit typecast here. Java automatically done it for you. And now come on the second way, like larger to smaller. So what we do now, like we have an integer x, y and z here. Okay, so the value of x equal to 2 and value of y is equal to like 3. Okay, so what happened here, like if z equal to x divided by y, so when this calculation had gone like 2 by 3, it's returned a decimal value, and this is a type of float, and this variable is in integer type. This is smaller than this float. Okay, so we need to typecast here, like put int this. Okay, so we need to write the statement like this. Okay, so when we typecast a larger value into a smaller one, we need to typecast explicitly like this. Okay, this is the actually casting of values. Now we learn how to cast an object. So casting of objects. Okay, let's start casting object. So this is like the same way here, your class name for type casting and your object. Okay, like we have in superclass like guava and a subclass like green guava. So how it goes, like green guava, declare variable like green guava, okay, double G, then a variable for guava class like G. Okay, now we create an object for that green guava class, like variable equals new green guava. Okay, now we will make a typecasting like in guava. We want to assign the value of this to this. So G means guava equals the type guava. This is the type casting of value, of object. Okay, which object? Object GG for green guava. So we are assigning the value of this green guava to guava class like this, and that's why we need to type casting type. Okay, so this is an guava type variable. Okay, so this is the way you can typecast your objects in Java. Now move to the next topic, comparison objects. We know there are some comparison operators like equals, greater than, less than, not equal. So these operators work only for primitive data types, but not for objects. Okay, but there are exceptions like equal sign and not equal. These two are exceptions of all comparison operators. Okay, so these two are used for comparing operators. Objects. The operator overloading in Java is not supported. Operator overloading is not supported in Java. Now take an example, like we have two string variables str1 and str2. Okay, str1 equals to hello Java. Okay, and str2 equals str1. Now compare, str1 is equals str2. Okay, and this is the operator, and now I am going to use method str1 dot equals str2. So the output of this program is true and true here. Okay, now we create an object like str2 equals new string str1. Now what's happened? This is an object. That's why this operator does not work here, and the outputs change when we use this two comparison. This will goes to false and this is true. So this is the difference when you compare the objects. Okay, now move to the third topic, copying objects. Okay, so like we have point p1, p2 and p3. Here are three variables. Now I am going to create the object for p1 equals new point, and p2 equal to new point. Okay, like you can pass the value also here, like here the 00 and here the 100 100. Okay, these are the point xy like this. So we have created two object, p1 and p2. Now I want to copy these points to this. So what we do, p2 dot copy p1. Okay, I have copied this p1 to p2, so now it becomes 00. Okay, now you can also make clone like this, pt3 equal to typecast point and then pt2 dot clone. Okay, using this method you can make clone of p2 object. Okay, and this way you can copy the object from one object to another one. You can also do like that, p1.copy equal to copy p2. So now what we do, we copied p2 to p1, then it becomes 100 and 100 in place of 00. Okay, so this way we can copy our objects. So come on the determining class of an object. How to determine an object class? Okay, so here's the way, like your object and then operator instance of, this is an operator, and then class name. Okay, so this is the syntax to determining class of an object, like phi. This is an string. And now I am going to use instance of operator, then the class name like string. Okay. So this becomes true because this is an string class and I am comparing using this. So this is true. Now like point pt equals new point like 10, 10. Okay, so I have created this object. Now pt object, now instance of now class name like check with string object, string class. Okay, so this becomes false because this pt is not an string class, this is a point class. Okay, then it return false. So this way we can determine the class of an object. Okay, so thank you for watching this video. Now this is enough for this tutorial. Thank you for watching this video. Okay, bye bye.